Living things are amazing. Every time you look closely enough at an animal, you're going to find something surprising, like bird feathers. There's lots of regular uses for feathers, but here's four species that have found some amazing and interesting uses for their feathers. Sliding feathers. Most birds get around by flying or walking, but the penguin has a different method. By sliding on their bellies on the snow, they avoid the awkward waddle that penguins are famous for. This is called tobogganing because it's like sliding on a sled. Not every bird can do this, though, because penguin feathers are dense and smooth. Penguins have many feathers per square inch, and they have a waterproof oil that helps keep water and snow from mixing with the feathers. Umbrella feathers. Herons and their relatives hunt fish by standing very still and catching fish from the water. But black herons have an extra cool hunting strategy involving their feathers. They stand very still with only their feet in the water. Then they spread their wings like an umbrella. With their head inside the umbrella, they look for fish. Their feathers create a patch of shade that fish might go inside. It might also reduce reflections from the water that make it difficult to see fish. Either way, it's a good way to use their feathers to get a meal. Paper feathers. Lovebirds have an interesting behavior. They are sometimes seen sticking paper or leaves into their feathers. This is a natural behavior, and its purpose is to carry lots of nesting material back to their nest at one time. They would chew a strip of bark off a tree and carry it in their feathers. Seems very efficient, and it works for them. Wet feathers. Most water birds do everything they can to stay dry. They spread oil all over their feathers. They have a protective layer of dense feathers that keep their insulating downy feathers dry. But there's an interesting bird called the Anhinga that hunts in the water and tries to sink. It has feathers that absorb water. Fully wet, they can dive easily. They swim along underwater using their long necks to hunt for fish and other food hiding in crevices underwater. On the other hand, the Anhinga has to spend more time drying. They can barely fly with wet feathers, so they sit in the sun with wings stretched out in between diving and eating. Actually, that sounds like a good way to live. This is already the fourth video in the Feather Function series, and I feel like we're not even close to the end of finding new ways that birds have found to use their feathers. And I'd love to hear if you know any, so let me know in the comments. You can learn more about the surprising ways birds have found to live by watching another video on this channel. Or you can subscribe to know when we learn something new about birds. Thanks for taking the time this week to learn what makes life awesome.